Okay, we are going to discuss about taxation for partnerships. So here, this updation is available in the Inland Revenue Department website. Here with rates, all the things available. The thing is, earlier, even in my sessions, I teached you that partnership normally not considering as a person in case of taxation. Mama kiwa person nirvachanaya karana kota palawen session eke wala hitiya na eka di partnership eka enne na kiyala. But that has changed now. Okay, now under person, under the definition of person, we should put the partnership also. The partnership එක නමින් බදු ගෙවීම සිද්ධ වෙනවා දැන්. හරි? ඒ වෙනස්කම් අපි දැනගන්න ඕන. If we go through the certain changes, okay, these are the things we should know in case of 2021. Already I have explained these things. In case of an individual, the tax rate has changed like this. Okay. Then 30% exempt, then 6% first, not 30%, first 3 million exempt, then next 3 million taxable under the rate of 6%, next 3 million 12%, on balance 18%. Okay, these summaries are available. In case of tax partnerships, okay, partnerships earlier, what was happened is there is a withhold tax of 8%. Withhold tax ekak thibba 8%. Okay. Yeah, that means in 2018-19, 19-20 mul kartu today. Okay. First three quarters. Okay. But from last quarter of 2019-20, the withhold tax was removed, withhold tax ek ayin kara, okay, then there is a tax of 6%. Then may 6% enne withhold tax ekak neme. Ekai man kiyuwe person yatate partnership enawa kiyala. And also here I have put, now when it's become 2020-21 and last quarter of 2019-20 awasane saha 2021 ඉඳන් tax free rate එකක් එනවා, tax free allowance එකක් එනවා, tax free වෙනවා 1 million partnerships. Okay, these are the things basically happen in case of partnerships. Okay, but here before adopting this, you should have certain idea how to prepare how to make our taxable income in related to the partnership. The partnership එකේ තියෙනවනේ shareholdersට බෙදලා ඒ කේස් එක කොහොමද කරන්න කියලා. හරි? ඒක දැන් LMS එකේ හොඳට පැහැදිලි කරලා තියෙනවා. But what I am doing, trying to do is discuss some examples with you. Okay? I will discuss some examples with you. Then you can have an idea about those. Okay? Then again, if you already didn't go through the LMS content, LMS content එකේ මේකේ වෙනසක් තියෙන්න පුළුවන්. මොකද LMS content එකේ සමහර ඒවා මම note කරා 18-19 යන ඒවා තියෙනවා. Okay? 19-20ට යන ඒවා තියෙන්න පුළුවන්. 20-21ට යන විදිහ මම පෙන්නන්න. Okay? Up to you. All the things up to you. You have to study. I will guide you. Okay? Okay. First sum. Mr. A and Company B. Mr. A and Company B. Okay? Not a Mr. A and Mr. B, Mr. A and Company B. Mr. A and Company B are equal partners in a partnership, again, one-to-one ratio for the year of assessment 2019-20, just forgot that. Make the partners like a tax calculate when you get a antibody of pen and the Hana may be set to have a visa had any key and egg. Okay. 19-20 the partnership has business income of 2 million and rent income from of 500,000 received from Mr. P gen ewilla thiyena rent income eka business income eka 2 million each of Mr. A and Company B will deem to have derived 1.25 million from the partnership. එතකොට partnership එකේ taxable income එක විදිහට අඳුනන් තියනවා දෙපාර්ශවෙම. That means Mr. A and Company B. Mr. A and Company B 12.5. එතකොට දෙන්නටම 12.5 million දාන්න ඕන. From the partnership debt, අපි අමතක කරමු. Will therefore from about taxable income from Mr. A and Company B to the for the year of assessment 2019-20. Partnership has deducted 8% of withholding tax from partnership income has paid to the Department of Department, that means Department of Inland Revenue Department. Calculate the taxable income of Mr. A and Company B for partnership income. දැන් අපිට මේකට අදාළ tax treatment එක කොහොමද කරන්න කියලා බලන්න. මොනින්ම පොඩි සරල දෙයක් තියෙනවා. Okay, now here I have listed here. Now we have identified that share profit of Mr. A and Mr. B as then partnership එකෙන් taxable income එක අපි හොයාගන්නවා. Personal tax වල business income එක හෙව්වා වගේ හොයාගන්නවා. But here we have given that one. 1.25 million. එහෙනම් ඒක අපි කෙලින්ම දාගන්න පුළුවන්. 1.25 million for B company B also that one. එතකොට company I partner I යන්නේ individual එකේනයි company තමයි මේ partnership එක yan okay so now then partnership eke api meeka haduwata passe then me tiyenne partner eken aapu share profit ek then meke di share profit ek aragena then metana patala gannepa then tax okkoma hadala iwara vela me oyalata share profit ek tama deela tiyenne e pudgalayata ena pud partners lata ena hari then metana e pudgalayata adala tax ek ganane karana eka tamai metana di siddha wenne okay එතකොට පාර්ට්නර්ෂිප් එකෙන් එන ප්‍රොෆිට් එක අපි tax එක ගෙවන්න පුළුවන්. එතකොට ඒක පාර්ට්නර්ෂිප් බිස්නස් එක ගෙවන tax එකක් තියෙනවා නේද? එහෙම නැත්නම් පාර්ට්නර්ෂිප් බිස්නස් එකේ ගෙවන withholding එකක් තියෙනවා නේද? දැන් කලින් අවුරුදු වල දැන් මේක person යටතේ partnership නැති නිසා කලින් අවුරුදු වල withholding tax එක විතරයි තිබ්බේ. partnership එක නමින් ගියේ නැහැ. කෙලින්ම partners ලා තමයි tax ගෙව්වේ ඒක යටත් වෙන. නමුත් දැන් tax එකක් ගෙවනවා partnership එකෙන්. Okay? Now that is just a tax credit for partners. එතකොට tax එකක් ගෙවුවොත් එහෙම පුතේ කරන්නේ ඒක ගෙවපු tax එක partners ලාගේ payable tax වලින් අඩු කරලා පෙන්නන එක තමයි කරන්නේ. දැන් මෙතන මේ ගානේදී in here we have given only the taxable. දැන් මේ tax වලට අදාළව ගණනය කරපු ආදායම තමයි දීලා තියෙන්නේ. එතකොට එක්කෙනෙක්ට 1250 ගානේ තියෙනවා කියලා හිතන්නකො. එතකොට ඒක තමයි මේ තියෙන්නේ. හරි? දැන් පළවෙනි උදාහරණ නිසා මම කිව්වා අවුරුදු අමතක කරා. මේ හදන හැටි මම පෙන්වන්න යනවා. එතකොට මෙතනදී නෝට් වෙන්න ඕනේ withholding tax එකක් අඩු වෙලා තියෙනවා 108ක කියන එක. Now you already know when we are calculating the income taxes of a person, personal tax relief එකක් තියෙනවානේ. When it become 2018-19 or 19-20 first quarter 18-19 වලට එනකොට yes I will explain in English also okay here the thing is now these profits have calculated according to the inland revenue act provisions those amounts have been given to you ඔයාලට දීලා තියෙනවා inland revenue එකේ ගණනය කරපු inland revenue act එකට අනුව ගණනය කරපු Inland Revenue Act එකට අනුව ගණනය කරපු ලාභය. Okay? Those things you have been given. Now what you are going to do is what you have asked to do is calculate the tax payable of Mr. A and Company B. Now you are not going to deal with the partnership. Now you are going to deal with individual tax of this particular Mr. A and Company tax of B. Company B. Okay? Now you know that according to the tax provisions there is a tax relief for per individual taxation when it become earlier now in 2021 it is a 3 million then oyala danno eka 3 million but in when it become 2019-20 not 2018-19 api 18-19 gattot ehema eka 5 million then eka meka damma kiyala oyala kalabala wenna epa okay man me pennanna me hadana vidhiya pennanda yan Okay. So here I just consider the 500,000 according to the previous act. Okay. Now into 2021, it is 3 million. Okay, tax relief, personal tax relief. Now I will show the way of calculating according to the new act also. Okay, now in case of companies taxation, there is no any tax relief. Okay, so we cannot deduct anything here. So value will be zero. එතකොට මෙතනින් කීයක්වත් අඩු වෙන්නේ නැහැ. එතකොට බිඳුව. මොකද මේක කම්පැනික් නිසා. Because this is a company. Okay, now company A is, now Mr. A is having this profit share from partnership. If we assume that he is not having any taxes, any taxable income from other sources, this is only one income available. Then tax reliefs we discussed 500, we deducted 500,000. Then taxable income 750. When it becomes company B, it's totally profit share, that means 1.25 million. Okay, then what we need to do is here, how we get the this now we are calculating taxable payable tax amount. For when it become personal taxation, already you know, according to the previous act, first 600,000, okay, after deduct all these reliefs, first 600,000 will be taxable in the rate of 4%. Okay, then 600,000 into 4. Okay, then next 600,000, it should be taxable in with the rate of 8%. Okay, but here we are not having a balance 600,000. So we need to consider the balance. Okay, or otherwise we have to go with next 600,000, next 600,000, next 600,000, like that. So here what we need to do, as here we are not having that much of amount, from this amount, that means from 750,000, we need to deduct the 600,000, that amount into 8%. Okay, this is the, then value is 12,000. මොකක්ද කරේ පළවෙනි ලක්ෂ 6 දැන් මෙතන අපි පුද්ගලයාගේ පාර්ට්නර්ෂිප් එකෙන් ආපු ලාභය ගත්තා. එතකොට ඒ ලාභය 1250යි. ඊට පස්සේ tax relief එක 500 අඩු කරා. එතකොට ඊට පස්සේ අපි ගත්ත taxable income එක 750යි. දැන් tax relief එක අඩු කරලා තියෙන්නේ. එතකොට මේක tax වෙන්නේ කොහොමද? පළවෙනි ලක්ෂ 604යි. දෙවෙනි ලක්ෂ 608ක් යන්න ඕන. නමුත් දෙවෙනි ලක්ෂ 6කට යන්න ගාණක් මෙතන නැහැ. ඒ නිසා මෙතෙන්ට දැම්මා. අපි මොකද්ද කරේ බැලන්ස් එක ලක්ෂ 6ක් දැන් ගත්තට පස්සේ 750,000 ලක්ෂ 6ක් අඩු කරලා ඒකෙන් 108ක් බැලුවා. එතකොට now what we did, first we got the share profit profit share from the partnership, then we deduct the personal taxation, okay, then 500,000 tax relief according to the Inland Revenue Act 2018-19 and 19-20 first half, then taxable income we identified 750, then individual taxation rate according to the previous year act. Okay, first 600,000 should be taxable under 4%, then next 600,000 should be taxable under 8%, but here we are not having 600,000, therefore we are taking the balance. Now total tax liability we got 636,000. Okay, we got the 36,000. Then in the sum, it's saying partnership has deducted 8% withholding tax. Okay, 8% withholding tax partnership has deducted. So we have to get that one. tax credit අපි ගෙවපු ගාන දැන් අඩු කරන්න ඕනේ. So simply it's a 100,000. Okay. එතකොට 1250න් 108ක් ගෙවුවා කියලා කියනවා. එහෙනම් එක 100,000 that is the paid withholding tax. Now we need to deduct that part. මේක අඩු කරන්නයි ඕන. Okay. We need to deduct this one. I will paint this as minus. Okay. Now we are having 36,000 plus 100,000. That means there is a okay, 64,000. Now the thing is, there is a remember this ayada hayala liability and withholding give what pass lakshya akkena. Then there is no any payable amount that is known as tax refund. Etoṭa next term ekin eka balance karaganna puluwan. I will explain those things under tax administration. These situations we known as tax refund. Etoṭa me gana gewan donnae mokada danatama withholding widiyata gewala tiyen. Now we already they have paid this 100,000 as a withholding taxes, but their tax liability is 36,000. Then there is a tax refund of 64,000. Okay, but in case of companies, okay, in case of companies, they are not having any reliefs. But previously, taxable rate was 28%. 128 තිබ්බ රේට් එක. එතකොට මේකෙන් කෙලින්ම 128 ගන්නවා. That is the total tax liability of a company. I will explain the things under when we are discussing the company taxation for companies. Company tax කතා කරනකොට මම ඒක හදලා දෙන්නම්. දැන් දැනට මෙහෙම මතක තියාගන්න. එතකොට මට note කරන්න ඕනේ. What I need to highlight is after getting this share profit from partnerships, we need to calculate these things separately in case of partners. Okay. Then we had the withholding tax payment normally in case of partnership, but again I am telling in case of 2021 we are not having this withholding tax payment in case of partnerships. Okay. Now we are having payable tax in case of company B, 250,000. Okay, here I have put here withholding tax payment calculation. එතකොට withholding tax හදපු විදිහ මේ දාලා තියෙන්නේ. එතකොට දෙකෙන්ම withholding tax ගිහිල්ලා තියෙනවා ලක්ෂ 2. Okay, this is the way we are calculating after giving this tax share, profit share, taxable profit share. Okay, but now I will move to the next question. දැන් ඔය taxable profit share එක හදන හැටිත් අපි දැනන් ඉන්න ඕනේ. එතකොට අපි ඒකත් හදාගන්න හැටි අර විදිහටම තමයි. මෙතනදී අපි සලකා බලන්න ඕනේ පොඩි දේවල් ටිකක් තියෙනවා. හරි. අපි දැන් ඒක කතා කරන්න යමු. Company A and B, question number 2. Company A and B, not companies, A and B carrying out a partnership with equally share the profits and income, equal share of profits and income. The net profit of the business for the year of assessment 2019 up in this moment also, just forget that. So 19-20 kata thama matak kar lena. Okay. They have earned this amount. This is the net profit of the business. Okay. This is the net profit of the partnership. Okay. Profit was calculated after considering following transaction. Now, after considering these expenses and the all our expenses and income, they have calculated this profit. Then, using the above details, determine the profits of each partner from the partnership. Determine the payable tax by the partners. දැන් මොකද්ද කියන්නේ බිස්නස් එකේ ඉන්කම් එක දීලා තියෙන්නේ මේ ගාන ඊට පස්සේ මේ වියදම් අඩු කරලා තියෙනවා සා ආදායම් තියෙනවා so what you need to do is determine the profit first of all we have to adjust this profit according to the inland revenue act so let's see how to do that one okay here as we did in the as we did in the business income calculation we can use the same method here also here we can put the accounting profit like this then first point let's see the first point royalty all of you aware normally royalty is a allowed expense so here no need to do anything ek adu kirima apita baddata anuwa piliganna puluwam so we no need to consider that one salaries has paid here the most important thing in case of partnerships other than the individual calculations දැන් අර තනි තනියෙන් හදනකොට අපි දැනටම ඔක්කොම වගේ ගනුදෙනු කතා කරලා තියෙන නිසා එම ඕනේ දැන් මෙතන අලුතෙන් එන එක තමයි මේ salaries paid to the partners ඊට පස්සේ interest on capital those things okay normally keep in mind the salaries and interest paid to capital are not allowed expenses in case of calculating account taxable profit of the partnership okay so if already we have deducted these expenses I mean the salaries of partners and interest paid to partners on their capital now what we need to do is the deducted amount this deducted amount should be add back okay these salaries for these partners A and B this A this B A B okay partners those are not allowed expenses okay not allowed expenses I will put in A not allowed so we as we already have deducted this we need to add back those then make ganne karanakota oka adu karala ne tiyenne etoṭa eka api aaye ekathu karannō and from B's one also we need to add back harneda kana yes interest paid on capital contribution B was 225,000 A 425,000 then those also not allowed expenses we need to add back ओके දැන් එතකොට අපි ඒවා ඇඩ් කරා දැන් මෙතනදී royalty එක අඩු කරා මේකත් එක්ක අපි එකඟ වෙන නිසා අපි ඒක adjustment එකක් කරේ නැහැ we are allowed according to the tax laws we are agreeing with this deduction therefore we just put it as allowed but no adjustments okay salaries and interest are not allowed expenses therefore we deducted then interest on bank deposit interest on bank deposit actually not a income from this business it's a interest income එතකොට මේ source එකෙන් එන income එකක් නෙමෙයි therefore it also a not allowed income so in case of calculating this account in profit we have at that one income එක add කරලා තියෙන so as we are not agreeing with this add income so we have to deduct that on api eka adu kara okay those are the things available now we can get some of this column they see 300,000 some of this column we can get the amount now we can deduct this one from this one amount is the partnership income taxable partnership income is around 8.8 million and 125 okay පොතෙන් තනකන් හදා ගන්න තේරෙනවා now the things save this now we have to get partners receives. Okay, then partners letter, then partners now in case of here up to now, as we readded the salaries and interest payments, or here when we are calculating the partnership income or profit from partnership according to the taxation, we have not considered the salaries and interest. Okay, then we are going to pay salaries and interest by using these partnership profit. Is that then make a hadalan ola council hadana wage then make a hadalan then partnership eke profit ekak api hadala tiyena then oya partnership eke profit ekak use karala thamai api me a ge b ge a ge b ge api gewanne salaries e tamatharawa eyalage capital walata interest. Okay, now already we have identified that the total profit, total then me okkoma gewwata passe apita ithuru wena pramanaya okkoma gewanda apita tiyena pramanaya tamai me. Okay, that is partnership income. We can first we can put that into here. Okay, then already we know the amounts of salaries. We are going to pay salaries by using these profits. So A is going to receive this amount, 1850. B is going to receive 925. If we need, we can put the total amount too. Interest also we can put like that, 425 and 225. Then the total will be like this. Then the balance after payment of the salaries and interest on capital, balance will be 5375125. Ekenne making me deka adu karahama ena gana thamai balance eka. Here profit sharing ratio, profit sharing ratio is 1:1. As profit sharing ratio is 1:1, simply we can deduct this one by 2 and put them here. Apita deken bedala danna puluwan. Then we can get total amount. Okay, oka 19 20 20 21 ek hama ekema oka thama hada. Okay, this is the profits of each partner from the partnership. Okay, then determine tax payable by partners. Now the thing is, earlier a withholding tax of 80%, that means 2019 20 and 2018 19 and 19 20 first 3 quarters 2018 19 withholding tax එකක් තිබ්බේ 108ක. එතකොට මෙන්න මේ amount එකෙන් partners ලා දෙන්නට. එතකොට මෙතනින් මේක නෙමේ profit එක partnership tax income partnership එකේ taxable profit එක බෙදෙන්නේ මේ විදිහටනේ. එතකොට මේක මත withholding tax එක වදින්නේ. එතකොට ඒක ඒ partners ට අඳුරගන්න බෑ tax credit එකක් විදිහට. The paid withholding tax should identify personally as a tax credit when we are paying the individual taxation, we should deduct that one as a tax credit. So we can multiply this amount by 8%, this amount by 8%, because the withholding tax payment is 8% in case of 2019-20. Okay, first 3 quarters. Okay, just ignore up to this moment. I will explain all these things later. Up to this moment, just forget those. Okay, up to this moment, just forget those. Then total withholding tax payment, if you need, you can get to this here. Okay, this is the scenario. දැන් එතකොට 2019 ගිය අවුරුද්දට වෙනකල් tax එක නිකම් tax එකෙන් partnership වලදී partnership එකෙන් tax එකක් ගෙව්වේ නැහැ කේයිම withholding tax එකක් තමයි ගෙව්වේ up to 2019-20 last quarter until 2019-20 last quarter there were not any tax from the partnership just partners paid withholding taxes okay then personally they pay other taxes according to their individual income okay let's move to next question layamu igawa ga Mr. Pereira and Mr. Silva are partners of a partnership which conducts a business of imports and selling electrical items. The ratio profit sharing ratio 1:1. The partnership has earned net profit of 43 million as per the financial statement prepared for the year ended 31st March 2019. The following additional information are gathered at annual audit okay salaries paid to Pereira and Silva has been given then Mr. Pereira has given 5 million to the partnership as a loan Mr. Pereira 5 million deela thiyena to the partnership as a loan in 2017 as at interest rate of 5% the interest has to paid until the year 2020 that is visata yanaka gewanna loan Pereira's wife is working for the partnership and ₹800,000 has been paid to her as her salary. Pereira's wife, not any partner, just the partner's wife. Okay. The partnership has taken a loan from Mr. Silva's wife amounting $1 million and interest paid to that at the rate of 9%. 9% interest ka kyanamalu ekata. The net income received by the partnership is 500,000 and the net dividend income received is 200,000. Entertainment expenses has deducted 400,000. Penalty paid to the local authority on delayed rate payables varipanam givima pahu vela penalty gewala 11,000. Book depreciation pottawalaage thiyena saya watinakama book depreciation provided for the Asset purchase prior to 1st of April 2018 is 1.2 million. However, capital allowances granted as per the law is only 600,000. 1.2 depreciation adu kala thibbata allowed wenne 600,000. ESC paid by the partnership for the year is 900,000. Okay. Compute the withholding tax payable by the partnership on its shares of profits and compute the income. Okay. Here, accounting profit has been given 43 million. Let's move one by one. Then salaries to partners already we know those are not allowed expenses. Salaries to partners are not allowed expenses. Okay. Therefore, we have to add back those. Why I am putting these amounts? Per month, 200,000. Per month, 150. That means we need to multiply those by 12. Okay. Salary is not allowed. Then... Loan interest of Mr. Pereira. What is saying? Mr. Pereira has given a loan. Okay. Mr. Pereira has given a loan of 5 million. Yes, Mr. Pereira, 5 million interest rate, take a 5%. Then that one also not allowed because this he is a partner. A partner can ekmisa. Okay. A partner can ekmisa not allowed. We need to add back those things also. Interest, loan interest. How to calculate the loan interest? 5 million into 5%, that is the annual interest. Then Mr. Pereira's wife is working for the partnership and paid as her salary is 800,000. So this is not a partner's wife. So it can be considered as a allowed expense. Okay, that is allowed. Then loan interest. Partner's loan interest, partner's wife has given a loan, so not a partner. Therefore, that one also can allow. Okay. Then other income. You know that these are from different types of other sources of income, not business. Therefore, we cannot add these things here. So all these things not allowed. These dividend income and the interest income. So when calculating the business income, we should not consider those. So we have to deduct those one because already we have add those here. Then add kala tiyena nisa. Then entertainment expenses 400,000. Normally entertainment expenses are not allowed in case of calculating. We know the veneva adu karanna denne. So we need to add back those. Then penalty paid to the authorities. Varipanam velawata gewala nathuwa gewala tiyena penalties tiyena. Enang ewa penalty gewana ewa denne waraddak karala tiyenne. Not allowed. Normally penalties are not allowed expenses because we are getting penalties because of we are not following the rules and regulations, so we cannot deduct those in calculating the net profits. Then accounting depreciation is 1.2 million. Therefore, you already know accounting depreciation not allowed. Therefore, we need to add back those and capital allowances we can deduct. Okay, then we can deduct capital allowances as expense, but all is as up to this moment we have not deducted that one. We can put under deduct category. අපි දැනටම මේ capital allowance කඩු කරලා නැහැ නේ මේ ලාභය ගණනය කරනකොට. ඒ නිසා මේ capital allowance ගන්න දැන් අපි අඩු කරනවා. Those are the things. So we can get the total of add column, deduct column, then partnership income will be this. So as we did in the previous sum, now we can have this amount. So total is 47671. From that, first let's pay the salaries. How much the salaries? 200,150,000 per month. We can get the total. Loan has been given. Now loan interest we can pay for the Mr. Pereira because he is a shareholder partner. Okay, 5 million into 5%. Okay, Mr. Pereira, you can get 250,000. No loan from Mr. Silva. Then total loan amount like this, 250. Then balance should be divided between these partners according to the ratio. It's 1:1. Therefore, total we can get like this. So, according to the previous law, previous year consideration, 8% is the rate. So total and particular values we can get. Me amount එක ගුණ කරලා ගන්න. මේ total ගන්න 8% මේකනේ partners ගන්න. Then another tax credit there. මොකද්ද? Economic service charge එකක් තිබ්බ නේද ගෙවපු? එතකොට මේ දෙකම ගන්න පුළුවන්. ගෙවපු එකක්ද තියෙන්නේ? Withholding tax එක දැනට තිබ්බ ගාන paid by the economic service charge paid by the partnership paid already paid එහෙනම් economic service charge already paid amount we can put here Now what we need to do from this withholding tax me gana veradi na unta then tendone this one minus this one withholding tax එක paid කියලා නැහැනේ ඒ නිසා මේ එක here this one minus this okay. here okay now let's see how to calculate the profit of the partners not the profits partners taxes Mr. Pereira and Silva, profit share we have identified all the values. මෙතන තියෙනවානේ මේ ගානනේ 24305500. Okay. We can put those two. ඒ දෙක. එතකොට salaries ඔක්කොම එක එන ගාන තමයි එතෙන්ට ගන්න. In addition to that, Mr. Pereira's income के लाइक दें। Mr. Pereira की income में क्या मौखरी मंदा रहती है ना? आह, spouse salaries are available 800,000. Okay, spouse salaries available. Therefore, that one can add. To Mr. Pereira's salary, total taxable income like this. Then tax relief earlier 500,000. Then taxable income we can get. Then first 600,000 4%. Next 600,000 8%. 12%. 16%. 20%. 12%. We need to consider balance. Okay, the amounts will be like this. Other balance, mama, excel sheet. Take that. No need to waste time. Okay, then tax credits. No, tax credit. What we have already paid. That means amount of these two. මේ දෙක එකතුව තමා ගන්න ඕනේ දැනටම ගෙවපු ප්‍රමාණය කියලා. Okay. මේක ගැන වැඩි හිතන්න එපා. ECS under tax administration I will cover that part. Just identify the value. Then final tax payable. Then tax credit in the sense what we have already paid. What partners already have paid. Need to deduct. Okay. then tika bile wage ne okay now up to now what I was explained is how to do this process now we have to adapt this process according to the Inland Revenue Act provisions okay I will get a copy of these calculations mam me copy ganna me calculations wala mam meten okay now let's now I am going to explain these scenarios according to the year of assessment 2020-21 then 2020 21 kohomada hadanne kiyala mam balan kiyala denna tamai 2021 19 20 tika amaru now let's see what was happened actually what has been happened is tax reduction is there what was happened tax rate decreased up to 8% to 6% then no withholding taxes withholding tax ekak neme yanne partnership ekak kelimma person kenek widiyata tax gewana tax free allowance ekak yana 1 million okay that is what actually happened now example 1 nothing to consider apita kelimma profit ekak deela tiyenne then tax relief in case of Mr. A tax relief may be then personal tax relief එක කීයක්ද ආවේ personal tax relief එක අපි කලින් ගණන් හදනකොට අපි කීයක්ද දැම්මේ individual tax වලද කීයක් relief වෙනවා කියලාද දැම්මේ tax relief වෙනවා up to a 3 million 3 million යනකන් tax relief වෙනවා එතකොට මෙතන මේ 1250 කියන එක 3 million වලට අඩුයි. එතකොට Mr. A personal tax එවන්න ඕනේ නැහැ. එතකොට මේ ඔක්කොම ටික නැති වෙලා යනවා because no any taxation as he has earned less amount than he has amount less amount than 3 million first 3 million exempt from the taxation in case of companies I will discuss that part with the companies taxation part company kohomada wenne kiyala man ek katha karanna and when it's become 2020 okay when it's become 2020 no any withholding payments no any withholding payments okay withholding tax payment එකක් කියන්නේ නැත but there should be a 6% tax on partnership profit taxable profit partnership එකේ taxable profit එක මත 100% 106% tax එකක් වත්. එතකොට මෙතන නම් මෙතෙන්ට එන්න ඕනේ Mr. A-ට අදාළව tax credit එක බෙදිලා යනවා ඊට පස්සේ. අර විදිහටම තමයි වෙන්නේ. එතකොට මෙතෙන්ට වෙන්න ඕනේ 1250 1250 into 6%. Okay. Then this is only what okay this is the not a withhold this is not a withholding tax this is a tax of the partnership but as a tax credit we can deduct from partners then metana 3 million pannala avoth ehema ara tax e calculate karana kota tax credit ekak widiyata a ge b ge meka adu karanna puluwan if we have in let's assume that here profit share is 50 million 5 million අපි හිතමුකෝ 5 million කියලා. Okay. Mr. A ගේ. එතකොට මොකද්ද වෙන්නේ? Taxable income එක බලනවා. ඊට පස්සේ මොකද්ද rate apply කරනවා අපි? අපි හිතමු 50 million කියලා. එතකොට 50 million ම දාමුකෝ. Okay. Then what we need to do? First the 3 million under 6% second 3 million no balance under 12% no second 3 million under 12% then balance under 18% then make a tax gone then from this partner we can deduct this as a tax credit this amount then මොකද කරන්න ඕන payable tax කියලා calculate කරද්දී දැන් මෙතන ලක්ෂ 50ක් තිබ්බොත් එහෙම 50 million තිබ්බොත් එහෙම මොකද්ද කරන්නේ එතකොට මිලියන 47ක් වෙනවනේ taxable income එක එතකොට මෙතන පළවෙනි 100ට පළවෙනි 3 million 100ට 6 ගාන tax වෙනවා ඊගාව 3 million 100ට 12 ගාන tax වෙනවා ඊගාව 3 million ඒ balance එක 100ට 18 ගාන tax වෙනවා එතකොට එන්න ගන්න ගාණෙන් tax credit කියලා මේ ගාණ ඒකේ අඩු කරන්න පුළුවන් 75000 ඕක තමයි මම කියුවේ ඕකේ that's what I explain to you Now in case of B, then B के बालों B के उत्तेजन ना कांग ओको महारी, okay profit टक हादर ने तो ये विधि ये टम तमाय, but when it's become 2020, when it's become 2021, no any withholding taxes, tax, okay tax amount having not a 8%, it's a 6%. Okay, then equal this amount. Other one is this. Okay, see it. Higher. Okay, this is the end. Then in example number 3 here no any ECS epathi end vidihak neha the here tax not withholding tax here tax on partnership It should be 6%. Okay. Now here, Total again, without tax payable, this amount. Then here tax calculation part. Yes, profit share is okay. Then tax relief here, not 5 million, it should be 3 million. Okay. Then ito kota. Minkai. Ito kota rangai. Ah, ito tara case. යාපත් දෙන්නටම both are getting this tax relief of personal tax relief of 3 million okay now here rates are revising first 3 million percent next 3 million 12% balance 18% Okay. Now, what can we do? Here, 3 million. into 0.06. Same amount will get here. Here, 1, 2, 3, twice into 0.12. Okay, here equals this amount minus 6 million into 0.12. Okay, then we make it this amount as tax payable. Then in case of partnerships, we have already calculated this amount belongs to these partners. So we can deduct that amount. අපි අර withholding අඩු කරා වගේ මේ partnership එකකින් ගෙවන tax එක අඩු කරන්න පුළුවන් withholding tax එක නෑ tax credit එක විදියට okay as a tax credit we can oh 2019-20 නෙමෙයි මේ මම ගන්නෙ මම 19-20 හදන විදිය වෙනම කියලා දෙනවා okay DA-19 පොඩ්ඩක් ඉන්න okay I will explain again how to prepare the these amounts according to the 19-20. 19-20 hadana vidhiyat mama wenama pennanna. This is 2021. Okay. Earlier I explained what you have studied in the LMS. That is actually 1890. LMS eke thiyena vidhiya tama mama me hadura pennu. Okay. I will put that one also. This is 2018-19. පොඩ පැටල් නෑ තමයි නික උරන්න දෙයක් නෑ this is 1890 and this is 2021 එතකොට මේකෙදි අර ACS කතා එහෙම එන්නේ නෑ ගානේ ඔකේ ඔයාලා මේ විදිහට ලෑස්ති වුණා නම් හරි if you ready for this one I think it's better balance 18% yes what I put balance එකට 18% දාන්න ඕන මම දැම්මේ කීයද Ah, I sorry. Thanks. Thank you. Thank you. Balance 18. Okay. Now I will show what will be the case in case of 19-20. Mama dahanamiya vissadi kohoma denne kiyala me gana hadala pennanna dan parakku wala nisa. Man pennannan eka me meke tiyena. Oyala meka balanna. Me 19 20 Inland Revenue Department එකේ මම download කරපු එක. Here you can see example. Okay, here the in this example you can see that one. Just here, see here. Okay, I will upload this one. Okay, if you need Sinhala or Tamil medium one also available in the website. Okay, see here what I need to highlight here less. Here A and B. ඊට පස්සේ oh and definitely I will share this Excel sheet and this all these three things I will share. Okay, here just point these things. Here same type of sum also available in this document. I will come to this point. Okay, personal relief. Okay, personal relief for first quarter in case of this is 2019-20 case. Okay, for first quarter in this sum, personal relief has been put as 375. Why have been put that one earlier? Then it got a method of in here for first period, we are considering 9 months. Okay, and this period we are considering 3 months. How we get this personal relief is normally according to the 2019-21. 19-20 that means earlier act according to the earlier act already we discussed personal relief per year is 500,000 okay but within 2019 within 2019 within 2019 we are getting only 9 months according to this 500,000. Therefore, මේ ලක්ෂ පහ අදාළ වෙන්නේ මාස 9 එකට විතරයි. So what we can do is simply we can deduct this one by 12 and multiplied by 9. Okay, this is how here they have get 375. එතකොට පළවෙනි මාස තුනේ එමය ගන්න. එතකොට මෙතන එයාලගේ මුළු ආදායම මේ මාස ගානට බෙදලායි තියෙන්නේ. ඔකේ? එතකොට මෙතන here you can see accessible income from the business as normal they have calculated some adjustments has been done just forget those if you need you can go through then according to the time period they have divided these taxable income according to the time period they have deducted how did they have deducted this is the accessible income from the year එතකොට 56250 කියන්නේ අවුරුද්ද ගන්න එතකොට අවුරුද්දෙන් 4න් 2 ගන්න 3ක් කරන් තියෙනවා පළවෙනි කාර්තුව විදිහට for first week පළවෙනි pace එක විදිහට for first pace they are unsure they should be 9 months so what they have done is this amount divided by 12 multiplied by 9 or otherwise divided by 4 multiplied by 3 balance part getting to the next quarter okay then personal relief get like that for second quarter එතකොට 18 last 3 months of 2019-20 අන්තිම මාස 3 as tax laws change for last 3 months tax exemption rate was 3 million million 3ක් exempt වුණා personal relief විදියට දැන් ඔහොම tax වෙනස් වෙන විදියට ඔහොමයි වෙන්නේ එතන million 3ක් relief වුණා it will effect for 3 months period of 2019-20 year of assessment 2019-20 බදු අවුරුද්දේ අන්තිම මාස 3ට ඔය ජනාධිපති මේ ඡන්දයෙන් පස්සේ අර වෙනස් කරපු එකනේ එතකොට මාස 3ක් තියලා තමයි වෙනස් කරේ එතකොට වෙනස් කරාම උනේ මේක ඉෆෙක්ට් වෙන්නේ මාස 3කට ඒ year of assessment එතකොට 2019-20ට අදාළ වෙන්නේ අලුත් ලෝ එකේ මාස 3කට විතරයි so tax relief normally 3 million So this is belongs to a 1 year, then 3 million divided by 12 into 750. This is how they have got this one. Okay. Then qualifying payments. Oh, ne kaka wot thehma. Then for first period. We have to calculate tax. Then we have to tax calculate. Carry. Palaveni ka toward mata kain. Kome the gatte. Palaveni laksha hai ta siya ta hatarai. Deveni laksha hai ta siya ta atai. But here, just considering 9 months. Apit laksha hai wat ani mein yanne to gote. Apit saaman nengan ne palaveni laksha hai ta siya ta visi hatarai. But here we cannot consider 600,000 because this is a 9 month period. So what we need to do. 600,000 divided by 12 multiplied by 9 450,000 ඔහොම තමයි මේ මේ 450,000 ගත්තේ ඔකේ here how did we get the 600,000 first tax revised එකෙන් පස්සේ after tax revised first 3 million second 3 million balance okay but 3 million for year so simply as 3 million for year as we did here what we need to do first slab අපි පළවෙනි පියවර ගන්න කොහොමද first 3 million නෙමේ මේක consider වෙන්නේ as this is effect for just for 3 months okay so multiplied by 12 no divide by 12 multiplied by 3 700 okay this is good and there are here some you can see some adjustments also in this document as here you go through this one okay මේක හොඳින් කියන්න ද ඉංග්‍රීසි එක තේරෙන්නේ නැත්නම් දෙමල එක ඩවුන්ලෝඩ් කරගන්න. If you cannot identify the English one just download the Tamil one. Okay? It is available in the Inland Revenue website. Okay? If it is difficult to read the English one just download the Sinhala medium one. Okay? Sinhala medium one, Tamil medium one, all things available in the website. Okay? Here I have downloaded the English one. Okay? Now you can identify here some adjustments are there. And also, I noted that in a YouTube channel also, this has been explained in real good manner. I don't know who is going handling that one, but all these things have clearly explained. Okay, please refer that one also. If you have any doubts, you can contact me anytime. I will support you. Okay.